Just like the Preakness, yard work is a rite of spring in this Park Heights neighborhood. The thought of the Preakness Stakes pulling out disappoints Angela Staubs.
Preakness is that one time a year where we feel special in this neighborhood. You know, it brings a lot of revenue into here. You know, it brings something great to our neighborhood. It's something historical.
The possibility of Preakness leaving makes Angela sad that her 16-month-old daughter, Lexi, may not have the same experience. So how did the city get to this point? The 2003 running of the Preakness Stakes is the watershed moment that spawned concern about the future of the race. The condition of the track was deplorable. Pimlico's owner at the time, Magna Entertainment, was banking on an infusion of slots money to rebuild the place. Annapolis politics killed those chances. At the same time, Magna put its plans to raise and rebuild on hold. Former Governor Bob Early considers it a missed opportunity.
We would have had four more years of income, or at least 3 years of income. We could have really had this substantive discussion with regard to what to do with the Preakness, what to do with Pimlico.
It is funny side, and he's heading home, back to Belmont.
Also in 2003, Pimlico's profits fell by almost 58%. Concern about the Preakness leaving never subsided.
How likely, in your estimation, is it that the Preakness returns next year and beyond to Pimlico?
I think everybody needs to hear this around here. The Preakness is never going to leave the state of Maryland.
Magna filed for bankruptcy in 2009. The Stronach Group purchased the firm. Old Hilltop isn't aging gracefully. In 2015, a water main break shut down many bathrooms at the Preakness. Now, 6,670 grandstand seats are out of commission. As Pimlico continues to fade, the Stronach Group has invested money into its track at Laurel Park and has publicly stated its intention to move the Preakness there.
We passed a law in 1987 that says the Preakness must be run at Pimlico unless there's a disaster or an emergency. One could argue they're trying to make it create a disaster.
This year, the city filed a lawsuit against the Stronach Group to prevent moving the Preakness. It also asked the judge to award ownership of Pimlico and the Preakness to the city. In a statement, the Stronach Group said, quote, "These actions are premature and unfounded. It has since filed a motion to dismiss the case, saying it's confident the law is on its side." A Maryland Stadium Authority study on Pimlico determined $424 million is needed to demolish and rebuild Pimlico, but it didn't include how to pay for it.
The owners of the race and the owners of the track have made it clear they don't want to invest any money in it. The city does not want to invest any money in the track. The legislature has no interest in investing state dollars in the track.
Ain't no stopping us now.
Efforts to push all parties to the negotiating table failed during this year's General Assembly session. It was tied to legislation allowing the Stronach Group to use state bonds to build a super track at Laurel. In recent years, the city has tried to revitalize the Park Heights area, including renovating vacant homes and demolishing 300 vacants to make way for new housing developments and other public facilities. But residents say it may be too little, too late.
That's just such a shame. When something has been here for over 100 years, I think that we should work as a city to keep it here.
Reporting from Park Heights, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.